It's the most important governor's race, I think, in Oklahoma history insofar as tribal nations are concerned. The current governor, Kevin Stitt, the most anti-Indian governor in the history of the state, which says a great deal because early in the state we had some difficulties with governors. It might be awkward for him, knowing he's a Cherokee citizen, knowing that he shares with me a heritage that goes back from time immemorial, knowing that his ancestors, like mine, went through so much suffering to find our home here after the Trail of Tears in northeast Oklahoma, to see a state imposed on us, but to find a way to work with leaders of this state. I frankly don't see how he sleeps at night knowing this. I, though, know what I have to do, which is do everything I can to make sure Joy Hofmeister is elected and that Kevin Stitt is defeated. He has gone so far out of his way to pick every fight he could pick with tribes, and he's really demonstrated that he just fundamentally does not see in the 21st century a place for tribes within the state of Oklahoma, that if we did not endorse in this race, if we didn't do everything we can to beat Kevin Stitt, I think that's malpractice on our part. I think it's a dereliction of our duty. I think we're duty bound to see this governor as close to an existential threat as you can, and to do something about it. If we all sort of flex our political power in terms of our numbers, if we do our part as leaders to sort of help our citizens understand the issues and get them registered, I think we can move a great deal in this state in terms of the outcome of races, in terms of what elected officials understand to be a high priority for us. I think had we set out this governor's race, we would have sent a signal that it really doesn't matter what goes on in state government. The tribes are going to set back and allow it to happen. They know now, irrespective of the outcome, that we are going to assert as much strength as we have to raise our voices. But I think it starts at the grassroots, and I'm proud of the fact that so many Cherokees have registered to vote for this election.